Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. We have ith root of 1 and ith root of 2. Earlier I have shown 1 to the power of I and 2 to the power of I. And in this video, we will find the ith root of 1 and ith root of 2. Before showing this, let me tell you about the polar coordinates of any complex number shortly. This complex plane, we have real and imaginary axis. And for any complex number z, which is equal to a plus bi, we have a as the real part and b as the imaginary part. The length of this complex number, denoted by r, is equal to root a squared plus b squared. And this a is equal to r times cosine theta, and b is equal to r times sine theta. So z becomes r times, which is a plus bi. Let me write this first, a plus bi. And a is equal to r times cosine theta, b is equal to r times sine theta. We have r times cosine theta plus I times r sine theta. And this is also equal to r times cosine theta plus I times sine theta. And this cosine theta plus I times sine theta is also denoted as e to the power of I theta. This is the polar coordinates for any complex number. Now, using these, we'll show. Let me take the first question, 1 to the ith root. Now, 1 in complex plane, 1 stands here. N is equal to, 1 is equal to e to the power of I times, theta is 0 here, the principal angle here is 0, and we write 0 plus 2 pi n, so 1 is equal to e to the power of, actually, I times 2 pi n. We'll use this for our question. We want to find this ith root of 1, and if we use e to the power of I times 2 pi n, then this becomes e to the power of I times 2 pi n to the power of 1 over I, and this is equal to e to the power of 2 pi n, for n being an integer. So the ith root of 1 is equal to e to the power of 2 pi n, n being an integer. For n is equal to 0, we have e to the power of 0, which is 1, but we have infinitely many solutions. The second part was the ith root of 2. Now this 2 is equal to e to the power of ln 2. So the ith root of 2 is equal to ith root of e to the power of ln 2. This is again e to the power of ln 2 to the power of 1 over I. Now this 1 over I is equal to negative I. I'll show you. So we have actually e to the power of negative I times ln 2, or e to the power of I times negative ln 2. So by the Euler's formula, this is equal to cosine negative ln 2 plus I times sine negative ln 2. Since this cosine is an even function, we have cosine ln 2. And since sine is an odd function, we have negative I times sine ln 2. And this is the principal value for ith root of 2. Actually, we have plus 2 pi n inside cosine and sine. And now this 1 over I is equal to negative I, since 1 over I, if we just multiply by negative I, we will have negative I divided by negative I squared. I squared is defined to be negative 1, so we have negative I. Thank you for watching and see you in the next videos.